NCAA tournament is all about Cinderella stories, and last year, for one brief moment, Coppin State wore the glass slipper, but Arizona was the belle of the ball.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
What a play by Antoine Berkington!
No bigger win in Coppin State history.
Cinderella is arrived.
If your heart is in your dream.
And a milestone victory for Arizona. Simon Says Championship.
Of last year's tournament, the Coppin State Eagles. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson, and welcome to Tucson, where it turned out to be a magical season last year for the Arizona Wildcats as they knocked off three number one seeds and are out to their first national championship. And with five returning starters, they've got a good chance of becoming the first team since Duke in 91-92 to repeat as national champs. And joining me today, my partner, Bill Raftery. And Raft, these guys have all the components to do it again.
Well, if you're sweet on perimeter play, and I know you are, Gus, you'll love the three M's of Arizona. Miles Simon, the ability to shoot the ball deep, great leadership qualities. He penetrates and does give it up as well. Michael Bibby, one of the premier point guards in the country. Great range and strength. Michael Dickerson now can put it on the floor, Gus, and take it to the rim.
Now they're taking on a team, Coppin State, that jumped onto the national scene last year when they shocked South Carolina in the first round of the East region in the NCAAs. And their coach, Fang Mitchell, he makes it clear he'll play anybody.
He won't answer many phone calls. The big ones don't want to play him. Fang says it's all about opportunity, an opportunity to play people and give my kids an opportunity. If they play and handle the pressure well today, he may be smiling at the end of the afternoon.
And one guy that's been smiling the entire season, Antoine Brockington, their sensational player for Coppin State. Fourth in the USA Today poll. Only two losses coming to Kansas and Duke. Coppin State 2-2 on the season. And we're underway from the McHaleson.
And Coppin State goes, man, man. Hey, we'll play a lot of matchup, as you well know, Gus.
Bibby up top to Simon, looking inside.
Good aggressive front.
Mike Dickerson. Patience on offense for Arizona. Jump shot by Bibby off the front of the rim, rebounded by Lewis.
A sound defensive team. They'll run, but they'll be patient. Good penetration by Singletary.
Singletary trying to drop it off. Ball is loose. Brockington picks it up and slips. And our first turnover of the game. And the Coppin State Eagles, located in Baltimore, Maryland. Very tiny school in the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, which is a conference comprised of mostly historically black colleges, and a huge season for them a year ago. They knocked off South Carolina in the first round and almost beat Texas in the second round as Bradley jams it down.
And that's that leadership ability as Miles Simon gets into that 3-second lane, seconds, draws the guy, and dishes.
And a traveling violation against the Coppin State Eagles. And handling the pressure is what they're going to have to do today, Billy.
Well, they're very good off the basketball, Arizona. The ability to find people. Here's the double screen, the stagger. Simon gets into the thick and draws the D and dishes it off. The big concern for Fang was how they handle the press. Not good. First trip.
Al Simon, who was the most outstanding player in the NCAAs a year ago, inside. This is an easy basket for Davison.
The matchup was picked apart. Bennett, who's starting to play a lot better, played well against Baylor, Texas.
Brockington sliding to the basket, and he jams it with the right hand.
Well, pardon me, Antoine Jameson, that was crunch time.
Davison again. Rebounded by Dickerson, and he'll bank it in.
That's very important for Coppin State. They force a miss.
They're not as good rebounding as last year. Of course, Mott not here and Reggie Welsh as well. Big difference. Reggie playing in Turkey and Turquin Mott playing the CBA. There's a 2-2-1 pressure.
Back to Singletary. Fred Warwick, corner jump shot. Off the back rim, rebounded by Kareem Lewis. Rockington for three.
Now, this is a confident basketball team.
Rockington with 5 points. Baseline, Dickerson slides to the hole and lays it in.
Now, in watching Coppin State, they have a problem once in a while in transition, getting back and recognizing people. A little breakdown there after the goal.
Rockington again, 15-footer. And this young man can light it up at 31 against Missouri, and Kemp's into this game averaging 22.
Once again, not back, not recognizing. The little kiss.
And a very quick pace to begin this game. Arizona leading Coppin State 10-7. 17:08 to go in the first half of play from Tucson.
And Gus, what did Fang say last night? If it's up in the 90s, we're in trouble. This is a fast-paced number for them.
Steal by Gremlin. Bibby Dickerson got a good look.
How early does Bibby give it up? I mean, he doesn't take the extra bounce. Very unselfish. It makes him so tough.
Bibby with the steal.
Numbers.
3-on-1. Dickerson inside and a foul.
They got the right call, I think. Should be on Dickerson, no?
So Dickerson.
Well, you think if Terry
for the ball is first.
You think if Terry is a great ball hawk. Look at this now, Gus. The position, the hands, the able, and now he just keeps his man honest and then gives it up. Now they got a perfect 3-on-1 break, and I thought that was a charge from my seat.
Troy Lewis in at point guard, a 5'10 sophomore from Randallstown, Maryland. He's got the basketball right now.
They play Howard, don't they, on a regular basis?
Yes, they do.
And how do they do in that game? They got what?
They usually beat Howard pretty badly. Shuffling his feet on the baseline.
Your alma mater. Incidentally, that was Tommy Nunes on the call, son of the NBA great referee, Tommy Nunes.
Already 5 turnovers for Coppin State. They only averaged 14 coming into the game. But this catastrophe press, they call it here in Arizona, causing problems. Warren.
Oh, goodness. By leaps and bounds. I mean, he challenged Bibby.
10-9. Arizona. Knocked out of bounds. Stay right here.
Just the more you watch them, you know why they beat South Carolina and took Texas to the wire. Bang King coach, and he gets after his guys.
15:53 to go in the first half of play. The Coppin State Eagles, no fear. They are running up and down the floor today. 15:53 to go in the first half of play. Arizona leading Coppin State 10-9.
Well, you take a look at the MEAC and Beth Cookman, John Chaney's alma mater. Rick Mahorn, and oh, this is alphabetical. Don't get depressed. There are more.
My Bison are on the end of the list there. Mike Bibby shot off the side of the rim, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Wildcats. So Coppin State, they have a tradition of playing tough teams. They beat Missouri already this season. They're coming off a overtime loss to Iowa State. 77-74 in Ames. But they have no problem playing whoever is on the schedule.
Not afraid. Good man-to-man pressure here. Negated. They are confident offensive players as Brockington does a little spin, twirl, and knockdown.
Brockington, a senior out of Philadelphia. Fang Mitchell found him playing in the Sunny Hill League. He led the public school league in Philly in scoring his senior year, 28 points per game. And he is a player, as you've seen already.
Sunny Hill League. Friend of dad, a friend of Fangs. Look at the penetration against this matchup.
Bramley can't get it to fall, but Davison will.
The big thing with Coppin State is you've got to be patient against their zone. John Chaney, as Fangs said, a big influence on his coaching career with the zone, typical of that.
12-11, Arizona. There's a half-court trap this time. Singletary slipping and turning it over. Sixth turnover of the game for Coppin State. And how do you want to beat this press, Bill?
Well, I think you've got to go over the top and make them pay on occasion. That was Death Valley. You got to keep in the backcourt and look for somebody to post, whether it's sideline or middle. And the dribble into that point, perfect trapping situation.
Arizona 6 of 13 from the field, all six baskets inside.
Nice look.
Davison, turnaround jump shot, short. Loose ball inside, picked up by Lewis.
Getting opportunities, Arizona. Coppin State dodging a little bit. Got to check out in that zone.
Singletary, crossover dribble. Tough pull shot. Up lefty, jump shot, and he buried it.
With Davison up? Oh, he didn't have vision.
His first two of the game. And Singletary gives Coppin a 13-12 lead.
East Side High in Paterson, New Jersey.
Didn't they make a movie about that high school?
That was Joe Clark, sure, the principal.
Dickerson.
They're going to make a movie about Michael. They keep stroking it. Federal way.
He's got seven.
He's enhanced his game with the ability to bounce now. Good pull-up jumper as well. There they go, over the top. That diffuses it.
Rockington exploding down the baseline, hanging in the air, and almost kissed it in.
They've got nice little patience once they beat the pressure, but the ability to get free, so important. And Simons and Dickerson use post rubs. The screen here by Bramlick gives them an open opportunity. A little knockdown to Jay and fall back. And then when they want to pressure the ball, if they're shooting, they get Davison up on the inbounds pass, they're awfully tough to beat.
Coppin State, they've made their last five shots. Rockington, the free throw off the front of the rim. He shoots 76% from the stripe on the season.
Coming up a little strained wrist problem, too. I thought yesterday's workout for Luke's guys was as uplifting. I thought they looked more relaxed. They had an NBA type of schedule. 14 days on the road, forcing you.
Bibby gave up his dribble. 10 points for Brockington. Jason Terry drives baseline, just checked in, hands it to Simon. And a whistle and foul inside.
A.J. Bramlett with the discard. How about Jason Terry being your first sub off the bench? Do they have some depth on the perimeter?
Also coming into the game for Arizona, Eugene Henderson. As Bramlett takes a seat. Full court pressure this time. Arizona switching up the press. They'll go half court and full court. We've seen both so far.
Well, you know, Fang was prepared for this. He said that's the key element.
Singletary guarded by Simon.
They drag your defense. I mean, if they ever got inside points, this team.
10 on the shot clock. Singletary popping out up top. Pena, two to shoot. They better get it away. Brockington from downtown, and he can't. He buried it.
Why waste the time, right? Get it to him. Perimeter people, so tough to identify.
He's got 13. Bibby the other way. Rebounded inside. Davison got it to Edgerson, and he's fouled.
Eugene, tough, take no prisoners attitude. Got to meet his mom out in Maui. Said she beefed him up. Keeps tabs on him, and he's improved his free throw shooting. But this is late. Everybody out, pressure in the perimeter. Very similar philosophies outside. Run a lot of the same stuff. And here, when in doubt, why not kick it out for the...
Wow.
Get the puppy set early.
Rockington, 7 of 8 from the field. He's got 13 points.
He's a catch and shoot, chuck and duck kind of a player.
Lightning quick off the dribble as well.
Your kind of game, Gus, you know. Don't give it up unless you have to. Here's the full court, not playing the inbounder. You've got to be patient each trip because this press gnaws away as they get small change. Bennett Davison. Little nickel dimer in the backcourt.
Second foul on Davison.
Not the kind you want him to get.
Here's Fred Warren. 17-16, Coppin State leading Arizona. Bounce pass inside. Lewis reeling to the basket, and he travels.
He got the touch. He's been looking for. He's got a little turnaround jumper down there.
Ooh. That's Edgerson.
Edgerson, yeah. I think when he turned and drew the charge after the walk, his head must have banged the floor. And right here, good control of the defender. Oh, he got it right in the face then. So maybe it was the head when he went back. Eugene can handle it, though.
He sits down. Bramlett back into the game. Coppin State leading Arizona 17-16, 12-16 to go in the first half. From the McHale Center in Tucson, Arizona. Mike Bibby hopping inside, had it knocked away. Single carry, all by himself. He lays it in with the left hand.
Nice protection too, real smart. So you leave your feet against this team, they turn the play. Play to passing lanes.
19-16, Terry off the dribble. Skip pass, Simon, and a charge.
Excellent coverage. And Fang applauding his guys. They got out on Simon, Gus, and still were able to take away the baseline. Good footwork, solid D by Fang and his guys. Coming out on the floor. These days we
11:47 remaining in the first half. Coppin State leading Arizona so far. Don't forget, coming up next, Duke and Michigan from Ann Arbor. Duke, the number one team in the nation, pounded Villanova this week by 20 in Michigan. They beat UNLV, Billy, and then they lose to Bradley, so they're kind of up and down.
Should be a great one, huh? Every year, tee up, and don't forget, Duke's starting to get good Michigan players, as you well know.
Shane Battier.
Handling the pressure, playing at your tempo is what Fang discussed with his players. Attack when it's there or back it off and penetrate like this. What a breakdown.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
A blow by.
Points.
To the 10, huh?
Biggest lead of the game for Arizona. Rather for Coppin State. Dickerson. That's an air ball. Out of bounds. Coppin State, no fear, 21-16. 11:13 to go in the first half of play.
And Gus, the ability to put it on the floor. A little lingerie move here as everybody's waving. Pick up the attire. It's squat time. Got to catch it.
Watkins can't hang on.
That's one of those unforced. Got to help the club. Squeeze the apple. How about some of his stories, huh? Gloucester, your college coach. What was one he was telling you? The athletic wear.
That's right. Mr. Fang's athletic wear, he called it, and if he wouldn't have got the job with Gloucester, I think Nike would have been worried.
Well, he and his pal Derrick Brown ran the scores. The rest is history.
Rockington with the steal. 15 points for him. Coppin State leading at 21-16.
High praise, Turry on Rockington. And Jason, extraordinary defender.
Quintebs guarding the ball for Arizona, just checking into the game, a redshirt freshman from Salt Lake. Rockington from downtown. How about this kid?
Unbelievable. Jason Terry sprinted to the corner and couldn't get out there in time.
Terry the other way. Loose ball inside. Picked up. Davison. He'll get a second chance and a whistle and foul. But Antoine Rockington is 7 of 7 from the floor. He's got 18 points, and we still have 10 minutes and 21 seconds to go in the first half.
And Gus, the ability to run the floor quickly. Look at Jason Terry on a full sprint. Look at how quick the jump can duck. The feet are set. Speed of release, so essential.
Tebbs with the catch on the inbound. 24-16, Coppin State. A shocker thus far. Dickerson. And it's rebounded by the smallest guy on the floor.
You get the feeling now, tempo in control by Coppin, making Arizona play a little more on the offense.
If they can't score baskets, they can't get into that press. Singletary in the corner, and these guys are electric in the first half of play.
Confident. Oh. They can put it on the floor. That's what makes their deep shooting such a setup.
10-0 run for the Eagles, who lead 27-16.
And look at them play the passing lanes.
Davison, power dribble inside. Bramlett with a rebound, reverse layup. Short, got his own rebound. And a foul inside against Troy Lewis.
Well, they got their opportunity. Fang's lament is that people don't answer the phone. And this is one of the reasons. On a tough floor to win, a 10-zip run. I mean, he's got some emotion on the sideline. Now, Super Stans. I know you watched it. I'm a little too young.
Yeah, right.
And that's how the name arrived, huh?
That's right. White Fang. A character in the old Soupy Sales, in an old Soupy Sales skit. And one of his friends starts calling Fang Mitchell White Fang. It was shortened to Fang. James, the rest is history.
James Williams, he said. He was the guy that dubbed them that. And that coach of the year four times. His assistant, Derek Brown, played for Gary Williams in high school. They got a lot of Camden connections over there.
Second free throw good by Bramlett.
And here's, as you know, you make baskets, you can press. But this team now has found a way to beat it in pieces. Here's a perfect trap.
Did a good job keeping this dribble alive. Crown Lewis. And they'll start the offense.
Tough gamble here. Trying to make something happen. You've got to be patient. The ability to coach with the continual right here is where you want to stay out of with the dribble, but they get away with this because the foul line postman does a good job. Here's the trap, the slide to the, here's the slide to the next natural, and then the post guy bails him out. So, I mean, real solid analysis.
Singletary trying to feed the post, knocked away, and saved. Winteb. Dickerson, he has it stolen away. Singletary with a hand on the basketball. 27-18, Coppin State leading Arizona. Singletary, the leaner, off the side of the rim.
Tiny Archibald, that reminds you a little? The lean, the NBA lean to get the foul line.
Can shoot. Arizona, they've missed their last 10 shots. They're 7 of 25 from the field.
Here's the motion now. This is where they're patient. Get good looks. The ability to go to the goal in this, particularly Singletary. Nice post up. So you just don't get that turnaround effectiveness inside.
Rockington knocked away with 7 on the shot clock. Bang Mitchell has his team extremely prepared for this pressing style of Arizona.
He couldn't have drawn it up any better.
Lewis. Watkins.
Now, Lute expected this kind of game, though. Great deal of respect for what Fang has done, and this zone just keeps forcing you deeper.
Tebbs, and he got it.
That's his game. Three-pointer can elevate. Pretty athletic player, too.
And a timeout on the floor. 7:42 remaining in the first half. Coppin State by 6. Welcome back to Tucson. The game summary, Coppin State and Arizona. And so far, the Eagles have turned it over 9 times, but look what they're shooting from the field. 79%. 11 of 14. Different story for Arizona. 31%. 8 of 26. And Antoine Brockington, the senior out of Philly, 18 points. 7 of 7 from the floor.
And then you throw in the mix, Coppin State with 10 fast breaks for 15 points. Arizona's bad shooting exacerbated by the ability of Coppin State to get out. And ooh-woo!
Three-guard rotation in for Coppin State.
Same spot, and good bailout by Lewis.
See Warrick on the backside, pull up, jump shot is good.
Terrific open shooters on the perimeter. The mirror image, in a sense, of Arizona on the perimeter. All this, Bibby and Simon on the pines. The zone, extremely effective. They'll exchange, they'll cover areas. You see the pointing in the background. Some man principles, now the corner's open.
Dickerson.
Great lead.
And he is keeping a minute right now. Dickerson with 10, 29-24. Coppin State, 7 minutes to go.
Arizona used to get these in bunches. They're trying to do, excite the game a little bit. Running the floor. We can see everybody overloads down in the inside corner. They don't react. You got to keep making, almost like against Temple. You get something, it works. Now they'll adjust to take away the corner jumper.
Simon and Bibby both back into the game. And Troy Lewis doing a good job for Coppin handling the Arizona pressure. He's only a sophomore.
Putting it right up on the shooter. You got to use the dribble.
Washington around the screen. Got to the basket, skipped through the hole, and an offensive foul.
Wow. I thought he was through. I mean, maybe through an elbow, but maybe a walk at worst. But a slitherer. He got through the crack.
And he averages 36 minutes a game, and the ability, Washington getting ready to take a seat.
Ability to get to the gap, and right there, you don't knock Eugene down with that. A stiff desert breeze, maybe, as Luke sort of controls the call down there on the baseline.
Sits down with 18 points, a little upset on the call. Here's a zone by Coppin State. 2-3, lob, backside. Bibby can't get the alley-oop. Henderson rebound, stick back, and a foul.
There's a nice read by Miles Simon.
And the McHale Center, a very tough place to play for visiting teams, especially for non-conference teams. At the bottom of your screen, only two non-conference losses in the last 10 years. Nolan Richardson in 92 and your boy Jimmy Boeheim in 1995.
We got lucky. Got a couple of breaks. Mr. Warren and Eugene banging the glass. And that time, that's what's wonderful for Luke, the experience. Dickerson found the hole for a jump shot. That time an alley-oop to Miles Simon doesn't go down, but they just don't pack the tech. I mean, Luke, everywhere he has won, then has won big time.
Henderson, the senior, the sophomore out of New Orleans, with both free throws, turnover, Bibby got it.
Boy, they go right for the throat when they get the steal.
And we're tied at 29, 8-0 run for the Wildcats. And another turnover. Terry, finger roll off the back rim and in.
That needs a timeout. He just signaled. He needs one badly. That's what McHale's all about. They must have seen the graphic.
They're on their feet in Tucson. Tucson, 31-29, Coppin State trailing Arizona.
The tempo of the game, Gus, excuse me. Arizona gets an uptick. Quick shots like that. Arizona ball, all of a sudden, Luke, the energy. Depth is a major concern for Fang, and rightfully so. The rotation of eight people, solid performances by Curry when he came in. Quinn Tebbs as well when he knocked down the deep one. Not a good play here.
Poked away, Lewis, and it's knocked out of bounds by Bibby, but for Coppin State, Bill, as I mentioned, they only average 14 turnovers per game, but they've got 12 in the first half, resulting in 18 Arizona points.
Well, and you're saying on the sideline, you can't control it. That was the concern of Fang. You see the deflection there by Bibby. Here's another great play by Bibby. Oh, my goodness.
Down to the hole, and he's fouled.
What a pass to himself. This is something you can't coach. Look at this tip to himself. Let's Lewis run under. He was going to elevate and send this one in. That's a good hard foul there. No injury. You can see the strength taking that hit by Michael Bibby.
Bibby had 18 points against Baylor on Monday, and he is the son of Henry Bibby, who was the head coach at USC and also a former New York Knicks and veteran NBA player. Second free throw goal.
Shooting better and deeper. And put a little poundage on. One of the premier point guards. Too many people in blue down there.
Singletary up the sideline.
There you go, over the top.
Warwick, jump stop. Knocked away. Simon tipped it to himself. Almost had it stolen. Terry from downtown. Got it.
Run down that basketball. Miles Simon, it was an even shot. He didn't let Miles get away with it.
5 minutes to go, 36-29, 15-0 run for the Wildcats. Brockington on the bench. Singletary driving baseline, triple team. Found Lewis, and another walk.
Too frenzied. Van can't get him to calm down. He wants the timeout. Terrific read. And that's the one I thought Lewis should have had. But the ability to go cross court and know that somebody's going to be home. The acknowledgement. Nylon, shoe off in, off turnovers.
So Fang Mitchell talking things over. As this team, who once led this game, now trailed 36-29. Now Sunday, beginning at 3 p.m. Eastern, CBS Sports hits the slopes for the Jeep King of the Mountain downhill series. Olympic medalists Bill Johnson and Doug Lewis head the lineup. Then at 4, Olympic Winterfest presents the Ladies Professional Figure Skating Championship. Karen Kadavy, Liz Manley, and Roslyn Sumners are all among those expected to compete.
One of the problems, other than the press, Lute Olson's guys energized a little bit, is Coppin State falls asleep a little bit in transition. They have a one-man front, and then they also penetrate, and they just don't get the balance, so the runouts in Arizona's favor.
So Coppin, who led by 11 at one time, now trail 36-29, a turnover as Pina steps into the passing lane and comes up with the steal.
Good play against Simon.
Simon spinning, dishing to Bibby, and they can't finish the play. Troy Lewis turns it over on the sideline.
Simon amazes me because he's more athletic than when you first observe him. Spins, handles, a toughness about him.
Bibby for three. And Brockington still on the bench. He only has two fouls and 18 points for Coppin State. 7-7 from the field.
Who's that remind you of? A little bit of John Chaney, right? Yeah. Two.
Foul inside against Arizona.
Coppin State will go up and down a little more than Temple does. Don't you think?
I think so.
He will get some transition points, although John Chaney's pushing the ball just a little bit more. He's got Greer and Moore coming in off the bench. Sanchez running the show. Temple, a very tough out.
So Kareem Lewis, 6'7 senior from Brooklyn, New York, the only returning front court starter, gets the first free throw to go. And Fang Mitchell has worked John Chaney's basketball camp for the past 10 years. He is a disciple. John Chaney considers him his mentor.
And the day he has, you know, he's there at 11 or 12 o'clock at night. They've got 17 sports. He's the athletic director. Not much time off for Fang. A long day for the coach.
What are you doing? You can't spare Pluto.
And welcome back to the McHale Center in Tucson. Gus Johnson, Bill Raftery with you. And that Arizona pressure really starting to cause Coppin State problems right now.
Well, the concern for Fang was you can't get enough timeouts. When the adrenaline's going and they're challenging you with this pressure, you can't afford the turnovers. You like to stop playing. Say, all right, fellas, you get here. Let's hit the post guy, turn, hit it deep. And in the timeout, I'm sure that's most of the attention, making sure they value the basketball better, Gus.
For Arizona, 1994, advanced to the Final Four. Lute Olson, three teams here at Arizona have advanced to the Final Four. In 1980, he had an Iowa team to advance to the Final Four also.
He's been quick and deep.
36-31, Arizona leading Coppin State. 3:31 to go in the first half. Dickerson inside, and on the backdoor cut, he lays it in.
Nice analysis again as Bramlett found them. Good cutting without the basketball. Dickerson.
He has 12. Eagles breaking the press easily this time, and Rockington still not on the floor for Coppin State. He has two fouls, 18 points. Warwick. And he's keeping them close.
I can't argue with that, though. That's your system and the way you're going to do it. They're within hailing distance. And they run their own little trap. The spreading of the floor with the three-point range.
There's that matchup zone. Cross-court pass to Simon in the corner. Again to Bibby. 12 on the shot clock. Dickerson, 15-footer.
That's that pull-up. He's so confident. Gets the puppy set. Big hard. Push with the last. Another turnover.
Dickerson with 14. Simon bumped on the baseline and fouled.
Trying to find holes, the key against the zone. Can you get in position? This is going to be the eventual dive. Michael with the, this is the pull-up jumper, excuse me. But the read before was the dive to the goal. I mean, he just gives them opportunities to score. Doesn't stand still, understands how to use the big guys for the rubs.
Miles Simon. A slow start for him, the leading scorer for Arizona. He has 1 point now. That is first basket of the game.
Now, his name, Miles Davis, named after him, and you had a little conversation. You were disappointed, didn't know much about him.
I asked him, what's his favorite Miles Davis album? He says, I don't know anything about Miles Davis.
Mine is kind of blue.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Thanks for your tip on that one.
Great album, kind of blue. Lewis. Warwick again.
Oh! Is he at home? You've got to get on him. He's the one guy I think you got to force him to put it on the floor.
10 first half points for Warwick. 42-37. Coppin State and a turnover. Ahead to Singletary, and Dickerson chases it down.
Think of the perimeter people, how similar these teams are. They stretch through the, all can shoot it way out. Go over the top, extra passes.
Bibby.
Didn't catch it. That's what made the miss.
Loose ball inside and a whistle and foul. And it'll go against the Eagles.
He got punished for hustling. I don't blame Fang either. He looks worse than he is in sounds, by the way. He's always coaching. He's generally talking to his own players. He's got a nice personality with the officials.
Don't forget, coming up, Michelle Tafoya in the studio with scores and highlights and a brand new Blue Devil team. That's Duke. They have a Fab Five of their own. Mike Krzyzewski.
First Price coming back too, huh? Ricky, pretty good. How are they going to get the time? They're so deep. Michael will find a way.
7 points for Bramlett. Second free throw off the front of the rim. And the foul inside.
Competing on the glass. That's what it's all about for Coppin State. To get back in this thing.
I'm just surprised, though, that Fang Mitchell has kept Rockington out of the game for such a long period of time.
Well, it, obviously, with two, he doesn't do it. John Thompson's another guy. I mean, you're going to stick to it. They're only six down. What's the difference? You've got him the whole second half. Warwick has done a nice job. All the replacements. Lewis at the point has done a nice job making sure he doesn't turn it over as Troy brings it up against the bigger guys. So I'm with him. I think he's smart. He's not that deep.
This year for Coppin, a little trouble at the free throw line. 66%. Over 70 last year. And against Iowa State, the Cyclones beat Coppin State 77-74 at home in overtime. Iowa State went to the free throw line 31 times. Coppin State 10.
How about this bet? Jimmy Stamos just gave 18 shots for Coppin State, 19 turnovers. I mean, it's amazing that they're only four down.
Here's a little trap by Coppin State, and almost a turnover as Bibby looks for Simon, and it's knocked out of bounds by Kareem Lewis.
Never got anybody in the post. Bibby put the, they're putting the ball over their head and telegraphing. And this team is quick with good coverage.
Terry. Coppin State trailing 43-39. Set it to two. With the deuce. Warwick.
They should be pacing this trip. End up with two shots versus one for Arizona. They run it down a little bit.
Lobbed inside. Lewis had it knocked out of bounds by Bramlett.
Good help. You forget Arizona's defense. And not as a coach, but the flashiness of the offense. And they cover, do a good job helping one another. Luke gets it done.
Singletary. And a two-hand rebound by Anderson. Bibby. And he's pushed in the back. Looks like he traveled. What a foul called against Singletary, his second.
He's on number 32, Johnny Singletary.
Ooh, you don't like to get one that late.
10 fouls against Coppin.
I think you're right. I think he walked first and got banged. Now watch this. That's one of those little small changer. If he didn't walk, they wouldn't have called it.
Mike Bibby, 5 points. Make it six. Two steals and two assists.
I love this line. He said, how are you going to rebound against Arizona? Thanks, said, by committee. Timeout, pause.
Wise play by Fred Warwick, the junior from Philadelphia. 45-39. 46.2 seconds to go in the first half. And Coppin State led, Billy, by as many as 11. But that pressure causing them a lot of problems. They trail 45-39 in the first. 46.2 seconds remaining in the first half of play. Arizona leading Coppin State 45-39. Don't forget, coming up next, it's Duke and Michigan from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. Duke, the number one team in the nation. And Michigan with Robert Tractor Trailer. Jim Nance, Billy Packer in Ann Arbor with that one for you. Coming up right after this.
Second foul. A little difficulty if their backcourt people aren't able to stay in the game and on the floor. And Fang, one of those guys that maybe old.
Singletary walks it over the half court line. Arizona extending that pressure. 22 on the shot clock.
Now, this is the old Georgetown stall game. Remember? The pop out from the post. As the guard comes down, they hide behind the postman.
Seven on the shot clock for Coppin State. Inside, and a whistle and foul.
I think they're going to give it to Bramlett. The guy did the right thing. He got it, made a good, strong move. Not much in the way of points or touches in a low post against Luke. And right here, one of the few times the gamble sets up the opening in the wedge there as they get good reaction by Edgerson. Nice trap, but a little slow for me.
Greg Hammond, one of two from the free throw line on the season, and his first shot too strong. Substitutions in the game for both teams. Bramlett sits down. Singletary also taking a seat for Coppin State with 11.5 to go.
Smart. Got the two. Why not save him?
The free throw is good. 5-point lead for Arizona. 10 seconds to go. Bibby. Simon put it on the floor. Hopped inside. Great look. And Edgerson misses the jam.
Oh, is that a killer? Wonderful penetration and find. You'd go miles to find that one. Eugene, the yolk on the brow. Get the towel and wipe it off.
He cannot believe it.
That's actually, he didn't get rid of it before he moved a jump stop, then moved that pivot foot after. But Eugene, the machine around the 10, gets one to talk back.
That's the end of the first half with the score. Arizona leading Coppin State 45-40. Michelle Tafoya will be along with Pennzoil at the half right after this message and a word from your local station.
Curl, kiss, knockdown. He is on fire.
Only played 12 minutes in the first half, but had 18 points on 7 of 7 shooting. And on the other side, Michael Dickerson with 14 on 6 of 9 shooting. He really kept this Arizona team in the ballgame.
He stepped up, he cut well, found holes. And right now, the importance of handling the pill as if he gets a hand on one, a master pilferer.
Warwick inbounding the ball to Singletary with Kina. Kareem, Lewis, and Brockington on the floor for Coppin State to begin the second half. Out fast inside is kicked by Davison. And statistically, Coppin State 14 of 19 from the field, but they turned it over 19 times.
It's amazing. 19 shots, 19 turnovers, and Arizona really struggling. I think they give this one to Bibby. A little contact on Singletary. How about the penetration, too? I mean, these guards for Coppin not only light it up deep, but understand how to loosen you up, drive gaps, and find people.
Bibby's first foul. Arizona also beat Coppin State up on the boards, 16 to 13, but they have 12 offensive rebounds. Just underway, second half from the McHale Center in Tucson, 45-40. Arizona leading Coppin State. Brockington drives baseline and a blocking foul against the Wildcats.
Davidson, number three, I believe. He has not been able to contribute defensively. That was a trap, and they couldn't get it turned back. Bibby doesn't bring it back out. You see Simon at the top of your screen. That was going to be a sideline trap, something they worked on. Bad inbounds pass.
Bibby, Arizona with the numbers, and he kisses it in.
Just a bad pass at the other end, opens up the floor.
19 turnovers in the first half, resulting in 27 points off turnovers for Arizona. Bibby with 9 points. And Singletary breaks the press by himself. Arizona by 7.
Arizona doesn't want the ball to reverse when the big guy comes up. They're trying to deny it.
And another steal. This time, Davison got a hand on it. Lobbed on the baseline. Dickerson power dribble.
Oh! Power assist at the end. Coppin has awakened this Arizona team.
16 points for Dickerson. Arizona with 13 steals.
Everybody looking to help. It's a straight up man, but if they get a chance, they'll trap. They got to run.
And Brockington shuffles his feet before going into his move.
Talked earlier about Arizona's offense, but it's their defense that does the trick. Davidson faces the basketball in the passing lane. It's able to ignite the eventual dish to Dickerson, who's free in the corner again.
Lobbed inside. Davison can't hang on. And Lewis with the rebound. Bibby Simon in the backcourt for Arizona. Davison, Bramlett, and Dickerson in the frontcourt for the Wildcats.
That's very important because that was a nice back cut.
And it's rejected and a foul against Davison.
Number four, I believe. And this is just well-designed, good, patient offense. You're going to see the ability to back cut as they use the post rubs from the right. Here's the fake as though they're coming out top. The lunge by Simon. And unfortunately, Brockington can't convert, but that's a heck of a play when you're struggling. Get to the free throw line.
So Brockington at the free throw line. And Davison checks out with four fouls. 18 points for Brockington. And the first free throw is off the front of the rim.
Stay on the line, Antoine. Now Anderson comes in for Davison. Coppin State in the second half, no shot attempts and three turnovers. That's not healthy for Fang. They have to be on top of their game, valuing the ball.
Second free throw, Brockington is good. 49-41. Arizona, Bibby, leaving his feet, and he finds Simon.
Extend that little trap outside.
Simon down low.
Pretty.
Nice play by Bramlett.
Last Simon, the end of the half, made a great pass to Edgerson that time. Could have taken the jumper. Very unselfish delivery.
Nine for Bramlett. 51-42, Singletary double-teamed in the corner. Brockington one-on-one.
Good hustle by Bibby. Got a piece of it. Yeah. They do a lot of little things. The recovering Miles Simon, a guy that sets up his team, and I think defensively as well, turns the energy level up. They don't want the ball to be reversed. See the denial by Bibby? They're keeping it in the one side of the floor. Almost gets the steal.
10 on the shot clock.
Nice help by Anderson.
Lewis wheeling again, and he came up short.
Down and through by Dickerson. Here he spreads to the far corner. Pretty look.
Anderson. Bramlett tried to shovel it, and a steal.
And well, a deflection by Dickerson, huh?
Rockington with the head of steam going up the floor. Sideline out of bounds for Coppin State.
Now Bramlett with a great idea, but doesn't respect the recovering powers.
Rockington, rather Warren, 51-41.
Nice screen by Bramlett.
And a tip in by Dickerson.
He's so active, whether it's diving for himself or to help his teammate. Once again, Simon, even though others might be energized, I think Simon sets up the tempo, the fervor, the ability to get to the glass, something. The jumper here off the nice screen and diving to the tin. And Michael Dickerson.
3-on-1, Rockington in traffic, fadeaway jump shot. Rebound by Pena, and he puts it in.
Going to switch the D here, gives him a chance with the field goal.
Arizona by 10. Al Simon penetrating.
Hit it.
Bibby, 20-footer.
Nice inside-out basketball by Eugene. Bibby with the presence to step in. Good find.
Bibby, 18 of 53 from downtown on the season. And the largest lead of the game for the Wildcats, 56-43. Warwick the other way.
Wow, I'm just saying, that's got to go if you take that shot. Oh, Bibby with a mistake, untypical or uncharacteristic of him.
Nice look, and Bibby with the quick hand stripped it and out of bounds. 15:33 remaining in the second half. Arizona up 56-45.
Johnson, I knew you were a great penetrator in your day, but you counted the house. Bibby doesn't. He understands, recognizes. This is a deflection on the penetration. Now, Eugene Eggerson gets trapped, and getting in to that three-point line, set the puppies. Nylon, Mr. Bibby, understands the game. When he does make a mistake, you're almost, I don't believe that happened, because generally, when he throws a bailout pass, he's got the guy in focus, doesn't have the shot, gives it up. That's why at half court, when his partner turned his back and said it was a surprise.
Pena inside. Got a second try and laid it up with the left hand.
And that's the second time he's gotten inside. They need some support in there.
56-47. Arizona. Dickerson, rise and fire, and hit.
Gotta know his number. Oh, and the defense is a three back. Everybody should have been tagged along the baseline.
Singletary, good look. Oh. And Pena misses the layup.
Oh, what a killer. Great dish.
Jason Terry in the game. Dickerson. And he is on fire right now.
He's got him on a string right now. They made the three. He made the three. They ran at him. This time, puts it on the floor.
Dickerson, 10 of 13, 23 points. Rockington. Loose ball inside, picked up, Pena, Warwick rather, and the fadeaway jump shot is good.
Confident players, aren't they the perimeter guys?
He's got 14. 61-49.
Straight up man-to-man now after Dickerson lit him up twice.
Dodge baseline this time, got the step and travel.
You notice that dribble penetration?
With the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. Today, Chevrolet has awarded over $6.5 million to the scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. 14-12 remaining in the second half of play. Arizona leading Coppin State 61-49. Coppin led by as many as 11 in the first half, but turnovers a big problem. 19 in the first half. Rockington fouled on the release.
The recovery defense got the tag. Jim Roseborough, who's the assistant to Luke, really works on the defensive end. They get up full. They want him to get back. regain position.
22nd timeout called by Arizona.
Did you talk to Fang about his community group?
No, I didn't.
Before the game, he was talking about it again. Fang's gang. And it's all about their motto's love, respect, and education. They bring kids and their parents to his game, so a lot of community involvement by Fang.
And the last team to repeat is national champions, Duke in 91-92. Arizona with the chance. Lute Olson talked about it.
This is not a team like, say, the returning UNLV team back a few years ago or the returning Duke team where they had dominating players like a Leitner or like a Larry Johnson or somebody like that. We're a team that has to be hitting on all cylinders. We don't have a lot of room for error. What I've told the guys from the first practice is that we're going to have to be at least 25 to 30% better than we were a year ago when we won it to have a chance to win the game.
Well, they got that X on their back. Down in Texas, hit the loop. Everybody's going to be stepping it up a notch, take a chance to knock them off. Interesting that he said they have to be hitting on all cylinders. I agree with him.
And for Arizona, their only losses this season coming to Kansas and Duke. In those games, they trailed by 20 points and staged furious comebacks.
Well, Donnell Harris, who finished that story in a second.
Inside, Edgerson came up short on the layup. Loose ball picked up by Singletary. Hesitation, jump stop. Pena rebound rejected by Edgerson.
Nice play defensively.
And an offensive foul against Tebbs.
Tebbs trying to avoid it. I don't blame him, but what an anticipation by Singletary. Luke's upset, as well he should be. He may have been moving just a little, but a great anticipation. But finishing Donnell Harris, that's what hurts them too. They don't have that big rotation. Fortunately, they found out he had some fluid around his gallbladder. They've addressed the problem. He had surgery yesterday. And hopefully they'll have him back by the end of the month. So that'll help this rotation.
Missing his fifth straight game. Brockington, and he got the shooter's roll. Brockington with 23 points, right at his season average, 61-53. Bramlett back to the basket. Looks backside to Terry. Back inside, Dickerson knocked away, and last touch by the Eagles.
He is so good at finding holes, Michael Dickerson. Good without the basketball. And when you're a scorer, you just find a way to get free.
Didn't have a great NCAA tournament, but did a good job in the championship game of holding Ron Mercer to only 13 points. Offensively, he couldn't get it going, but defensively, his game did not struggle. Ball knocked back out, and a new shot clock for the Wildcats.
A nice cut again by Dickerson.
Hanging in the air, count the bucket, and the foul.
And Jason Terry on the money. The ability to get free. Dickerson, one of those guys who just seems to understand where to go, what position. Here's his dive. The ability off the dribble with a hook pass by Jason Terry. You think of him for D. Look at that. That is gorgeous. A little hang, a little smooch there.
26 points, and you just think he grew up boxing. His father was a boxer, a pro boxer, and he gave up the sport, he said, because he was tired of getting hit. So not only a good athlete, but a wise man.
A little carry here. He can read the financial pages now, huh? A lot of the concentration has been on that carry this year. Maybe a reaction to Allen Iverson. What do you think?
A steal. Dickerson.
Curry. Two big plays. Not bad for a six man.
Arizona turning up the heat out here in the desert. Cross court. Warwick. Double team. Warwick, and quietly, Billy, he has had a really nice game.
They make shots, Gus.
17 points.
Don't need the inside points this team.
And a hand-checking foul against Terry. Rather, Singleton, his third.
Foul is on number 32, Davison. Singletary's third personal, second team foul.
11:47 remaining in the second half. Arizona leads at 66-58. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Avant.
Coppin State hanging tough, 66-58, trailing Arizona. 11:47 to go. They will play anybody, folks. Their non-conference schedule consists of Connecticut, Arizona, Missouri, Oklahoma, Wisconsin, and Iowa State.
He's amazing. He may be the Magnificent Seven. They don't play many people.
Tipped away by Pena. Great defensive effort by Coppin. And Tebbs with the foul.
Aggressive, athletic, and can shoot the basketball. I think Jason Terry came up with that idea, right?
That's right.
Catastrophe. What they do?
He had plenty of time to think about it. He was a bellhop at the Sheraton Hotel in Seattle in the offseason. So while he was waiting to carry people's bags, he was thinking of creative things for the Arizona team.
And speaking of creative offenses against the press, one of the few times they're able to attack and knock it down.
Almost another steal by Brockington. Coppin State, you can feel the momentum shifting a bit. Trailing by six. 11:20 to go in the second half of play.
The ability to go deep, something they haven't been able to do too much. Over the top, you see the gamble by Bramlett. Send it in, big fella. Very well done. They don't go away.
Terry, partially blocked, picked up by Edgerson. Knocked out of bounds, and the Wildcats turn the ball over.
Gus Johnson, picture yourself going into Mr. Fang's athletic wear and not wanting to buy something. You think he'd get out of there?
No.
He'd be all over you.
No.
This shirt looks good. Take this suit. That's the way his team plays. They don't step back.
He sells you on that stuff. And Singleton selling that play, got the roll, Coppin down by four.
He should have gone to the foul line, too. Nice little hang and took the bump.
Eagles on a 15-5 run. Arizona's led by as many as 14. Singletary hurdling the scorer's table. And what a good defensive effort by the Singletary.
Oh, my goodness.
Senior from Patterson.
Linebacker move, huh?
Actually,
did you say Danny or Mike? Singletary. Hurdling. Oh, they're just so confident, Gus.
No fear. Danny Singletary walked on the Coppin State basketball team. Originally came to play baseball and has a good opportunity to play in the professional ranks at the end of the season. He's got a couple of tryouts coming up, he told me. Simon, who's been quiet. The English won't go for him. Inside and knocked out of bounds by the Eagles.
Uncanny ability to get close to the 10, Miles Simon. The zone does give up some penetration, but they gather forces by the rim. Maybe Pena from the rear. Interesting to watch his practice yesterday. Long. Arduous, not much rest, continual, and that's why they're capable of hanging tough late, still coming up with the full court pressure. Well-conditioned team, Arizona.
Hey. 66-62, Arizona leading, Terry in traffic, and they turn it over. Brockington up the floor. Pull-up jump shot, had it blocked by Bramlett.
Nice double up by A.J.
Simon wide open.
Good acknowledgement by Terry.
And Simon, prior to that basket, only had 2 points. And he's done a good job, Bill, of letting the game come to him and not forcing his offense.
Good, strong leadership qualities.
Singletary.
Here he is again. They got numbers.
Dickerson back to Simon. And a jam with two hands.
Simon says, let me step up.
7 points for Miles Simon. Singletary hustling it down, and the layup won't go for him.
Pretty good effort. Nice try. Got to take it. Well, Miles getting on the glass, igniting the break. And right here, watch him avoid the charge in the open floor. A little slide by, and now continuing. AJ thought he had a deuce. Miles says, I'll finish.
Coppin had cut it to four, but Arizona extending the lead, 71-62. Inside, Bramlett, one-hand catch, and the baby hook is good.
And that's his trademark, a little jump hook. They come at you in spurts.
And Fang is on his feet on the bench.
This pass leads right to the goal. Terry enables the catch, the finish, by a wonderful read. He has had solid minutes consistently through the course of his career.
Miles Simon, a very big part of this Arizona team, the Final Four last year. The 1997 NCAA tournament was the coming out party for Miles. He led the Wildcats to the title and was named the most outstanding player of the tournament. Here's a guy that missed the first 11 games of last season because of academic problems, but as Luke told us last night at dinner, when he concentrates and focuses, he can be a good student, which is apparent. He has a 3.2 grade point average.
I don't think you have to worry about him at all. That is a pretty good combo, isn't it? And with Terry to compliment if Simon's off or if Bibby's a little bit off or if they need the freedom together.
Ahead to Brockington, pull up three. 73-62, Arizona on a 7-0 run. Terry to the hole. And somehow he holds on to get at the ball.
That's impressive. This is why you hit the weight room, Gus. And I know with your impressive physique, you spend some time with that sin. But the gamble pass here. Impressive, huh? Take the hit and get a chance for three.
And Jason Terry unable to complete the three-point play. They find Warwick, who had leaked out. Warwick had a steam. And the tip up is good.
And that was just the last by Arizona. And they had three guys back. Everybody went to the rim with the dribbler.
Tyran Watkins. Terry again. Wild shot. Knocked out of bounds and jump ball the call. The possession arrow in the favor of Arizona. Eight minutes, 26 seconds remaining in the second half, 75-64. Wildcats trying to improve to 7-2, and Simon fouled at the top of the arc by Lewis.
And during that little play, there's movement, and it's usually Dickerson. He's cutting, filling, and you can see the little bump there. That's what caused the problem. Eugene does get his money's worth out there, too. Dickerson free to create space.
Terry from deep.
Inside out. Tough to defend.
Jason Terry, 17 of 51 from the three-point line, 33%. Hits a bomb. And he makes it a 78-64 game and a turnover by the Eagles.
And he turns to the student section. While you look for energy, the ability to get the press set. They also know they're going to get coverage in the back, so they'll gamble, Gus. Great effort, Terry, the old playground play, and lead the band.
I know a place.
This is not a country for wimps.
Welcome back to Tucson, the game summary. Coppin State, 24-43. Arizona, 28 of 60, but the big key, turnovers. Coppin State averages only 14 on the season, 25 in this game so far. Dickerson and Brockington, the offensive stars for each team.
They keep beating themselves. Punishment. And here's a turnover. I look for them to make a little run there. And they're such a confident deep, and they shoot the deep jumper.
Brockington got it back and laid it in. What elevation by this young man.
How about the reaction, too?
Simon the other way. And he's fouled. Since Coppin State cut the deficit to 4 at 66-62, Arizona has exploded on a 16-2 run.
The quickness of the feet, because you know when you can, you don't have possession of the basketball or there's a jar, you can get it quickly, but that was impressive nevertheless. And the counter, Miles has got some ticker, and he went as strong as you could at the 10.
And the first free throw off the back of the rim. Miles Simon on the season shoots 73%. And the second one is good. The senior from Fullerton, California.
Ooh, Eugene there late. That's where you get those eye problems, to reach in. They face guard the inbound. Davison not on the floor. They usually back off and front the inbound receiver.
Now the bowl season is coming up, and CBS Sports has a big-time lineup. The marquee matchup is the FedEx Orange Bowl, where Heisman hopeful Peyton Manning and coaching legend Tom Osborne make their final collegiate appearances. And Warwick with the first free throw. Other games include the Iowa Hawkeyes and Arizona State Sun Devils in the Norwest Sun Bowl, Kansas State and Syracuse in the Fiesta Bowl, and the UCLA Bruins take on the Texas A&M Aggies in the Southwestern Bell Cotton Bowl Classic. Two free throws good by Warwick, 79-68. He's got 19. And the turnovers, 25-17.
And now the man-to-man, they're running their little post screens.
Carey. Rebounded by Lewis.
So dangerous, this team. They linger around, and there's a reach in. Not a good foul. It just may have been Dickerson. That's a small change.
And Singletary, who is left-handed against Missouri, went down hard on the baseline and jammed his finger against the base of the basket. That has been causing problems for him. Singletary right now heading to the line, and he's kind of working that left hand out.
Yeah, that was not a good foul when you think of it. Put him on the foul line.
And Dickerson with four fouls takes a seat.
And there's that incident that caused the problem. And not a good foul when you stop it, give him a chance to get a couple.
12 points for Danny Singletary. Transferred from Ohio Valley College. He's a National Small College All-American, averaged 27 points a game. Second free throw is good. All MEAC in baseball, led the conference in home runs, batted over 400. Conference I played in. It's Howard and the rest of those guys.
You know it's a powerful conference if you played in it.
No, not at all.
Under 10 right now. It's a big trip, I think, for Arizona.
Simon down low. Bramley, great catch. And Davison is there for the follow, but it rattled out. Knocked out of bounds, last touch by Arizona.
Just off their game a little, but you have to attribute the banging, the presence inside as everybody gathers at the rim with this Coppin State team. You can see they don't give you an easy opportunity. Always a body.
Down by 9, under 7 to play. Singletary, wraparound pass to Warwick. Pull up, jump shot.
That was big.
Stay winning! Stay winning!
Bramlett.
Nice pass.
Davison changing his shot. Laid it up on the reverse side with the left hand.
I thought he was going to get in trouble with that little weather. Catch it and finish. Nice pass again by Bramlett.
It has a 35-inch vertical leap.
They got a 10-second violation. The difficulty to use the right hand, and right here, the interior passing, the selection, that's the one, little kiss with the left hand. Bennett wants to give a little agita to Lute Olson. Go up strong.
Davison last year during a practice session at the tournament, he injured his elbow underneath again. The layup won't go, but Bramlett is there to follow. Davison injured his elbow on the rim. Dunking.
Doesn't surprise you, does it? good lift on that jump shot, Rocky said. But Bennett goes a little faster than he has to. That's why he missed that last layup. Just back it off a tad.
Skip pass to Bibby in the corner. Terry, partially blocked, came up short, rebounded by Lewis. Coppin State still hanging around, 5:29 to play, 83-72.
Don't invite them to dinner, they don't go home.
Warwick, air ball, partially blocked. Terry with the rebound, pushing it up the floor. Simon, backpedals for three, got it.
That's where the game stays, huh? Guys, he got it open, look, now let me get the three.
11 point for Miles.
The spreading of the floor, Arizona style. So many knockout guys deep.
Rockington underneath. Lewis and a foul on Bramley.
We sat, I sat with Lester Connor yesterday at the number practice. Lester, former NBA player, Oregon State. The release on this shot, it comes out almost like a scroogey. Off the pinky more than straight ahead. But the result is what counts. And the other thing, it's on the shoulder. And NBA, he's going to have to get it up over the head a little bit.
Lewis' first free throw is good. He has 5 points and 8 rebounds today. Senior from Brooklyn. Coppin State under Fang Mitchell, basically sticking with Philadelphia area players, 4 on the team this year.
Well, they go with their strengths, he said. That's where his center of influence happens to be.
.450 remaining, 86-74. 2-3 zone by the Eagles, lobbed inside, knocked away, picked up by Brockington. Rockington popping out, guarded by Simon, got the screen.
Oh, goodness.
Got down the baseline, strong to the hole. Oh, what a slick play by Rockington. He has 29.
They don't get back again. That's their downfall. What a blow by him for one end. When Arizona goes for that jugular quickly. Here's another one by Curry. Good kick out.
To Simon for three. 88-76. 4:02 to go in the second half of play. The Coppin State Eagles 2-2 out of the MEAC Conference. Historically black college basketball. Coppin located in Baltimore, Maryland, and they're trying to play giant killers today.
Here's the rotation, and Jason with the hands.
With the steal. He's got teammates with him, and he gives it up unselfishly and lets the big fella get a jam.
Well, they worked hard all game, right? Teamed up, banging the glass, and Curry, Dickerson first, and then Curry sticking it in. Awesome defensive maneuver.
Terry established a team record for steals last year with 85. Here he is again, leading the break. Touch pass, Simon, reverse layup, and they're running him out of the gym.
Explosive.
Largest lead of the game for Arizona, 92-76. Led by the defensive efforts of Jason Terry, coming up with steals.
Nice flare screen here. Warwick with the long one. Well, Fang said they get in the 90s, we're in trouble. And he was right on the number.
Simon, pump fake, leads inside, got his own rebound. Another ball fake, caught the bucket and the foul.
Now, did that play remind you of the NCAA picture that we just put on earlier? He's a wonderful step-under guy. The confidence that seniors possess. Turn the corner, there's the pump, the step-under. Normally, that's a nylon delivery, but the understanding and the aggressive nature to compete and get after it.
And the great thing about his game, Bill, he's got that in-between game that you don't see a lot at the next level.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times when they brought that three-point line in last year and the years before, everybody wanted to shoot the three. Nobody's really guard-wise utilizing that in-between game from about 20 feet and in.
He's as talented as you can get in that foul line area, too. The way he pumps and gets guys and finds people, too, gets them up in the air.
Singletary going glass. got his own rebound. The land of the trees, reverse layup won't go, and a foul over the back.
Well, Watkins trying to body up. They are just getting punished on the glass, though. Having their troubles. 15 rebounds more by Arizona.
Don't forget, coming up next, the number one team in the country on CBS, Duke. Mike Krzyzewski with all those talented freshmen against a team that used to have five pretty good freshmen themselves and still with some good talent, the Michigan Wolverines, Robert Tractor Trailer and Lewis Bullock.
How about Wojo and Trajan? I mean, they're not babies. They're not too bad, are they?
Not at all.
Rashawn McLeod?
That's right.
He's got a nice little compliment.
94-76, 2:19 to go. Warwick head of steam. Lays it up, missed the bunny, and the rebound by Pena as he draws the foul.
It's interesting to watch Coppin State. Now, they'll play patiently, but they're explosive, too. They'll give them that free reign. You see him turn it up a notch. Get to the rim with a great deal of alacrity.
Alacrity? Oh, an SAT word during final exam time. Pena's free throw in and out. Coppin State, still they will have meetings with Oklahoma and Wisconsin later on during the season. 2:16 to play, 94-77. Welcome back to Tucson, our game reset. Both teams over the limit. One 20-second timeout for Coppin. And the Wildcats have two fouls. Coppin with one, the possession arrow, favoring the Eagles. 94-77, 2:16 to go in the second half. And substitutions in the game for Arizona. Wessel wears number 30 for Coppin State, as well as Tebbs, number 24, rather for Arizona. Terry penetrating. Edgerson driving to the hole, strong, high off the glass and in.
How did he do that? Tiptoe, to the tubes by the big fella. Not much room down there. And I think you see him coming. Look at how close. What great control. Clear out for him, Luke. Give him a little room. With the bounce in his game.
Sophomore from New Orleans, 6'2". Rather 6'6", 221.
St. Augustine, too. Curry Kills High School.
Gary, what a terrific pro career he's getting off to.
Great story. Top-notch guy, too.
Singletary. And Edgerson, another rebound.
Well, Pang, these are one of the great stories in the NCAA when you think of a Coppin State. But when he goes to the NCAA in the coaches' meeting, as Ted's teasing up, he's going to have to take coaches out to dinner. It's nice to play here.
That's
because
right.
The phone call's not going to work.
99-77. Arizona.
Nice pass.
Rockington came up a little bit short, rebounded by Ted. Terry kept his balance, pops inside the running jump shot, got his own rebound, came up short. And one thing Fang Mitchell told us yesterday is that his team, he wants them to compete early, play good teams, to find out what your problems are. But more than that, it's about the challenges in college basketball, and he thinks that that can help these guys in life overcoming obstacles in foreign circumstances.
And he said that John Chaney was a major influence in that philosophy for him.
Meanwhile, Rockington, a career high, 32 points today. And the most valuable players today, Antoine Rockington had 32 points, 12 of 18 shooting. Now, Mike Dickerson had a sensational game, but look at the all-around numbers for Jason Terry. 10 points, 9 assists, 6 steals, and 3 rebounds.
A nudge, a nice read here by Single Terry. And he's strong, send it in. They are a nice basketball team.
Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and assist those in financial need. So 3 seconds to go, and that is the ball game. From the McGale Center in Tucson, the Arizona Wildcats improved to 7-2. They're the sixth-ranked team in the nation. And Coppin State falls to 2-3. Coming up next, Michelle DeFoya in New York with the postgame show. For Bill Raftery, this is Gus Johnson saying so long from the desert.